Hello students, today we are going to continue with the chapter The Sectors of Indian Economy. In the last video, we have discussed about the sectors of Indian economy and comparison between the three sectors, right? And in this video, we are going to continue with the chapter that is Sectors of Indian Economy. And next topic is GDP, Gross Domestic Product. What is GDP? GDP means the things that are produced in the country, the total value of that is known as GDP. The final goods, the final things that we are using or we are exporting, the whole sum is known as the GDP. The whole sum of the things, final things that is made up in the country within a particular year, is known as GDP. Let's see. What is GDP? The value of final goods and services, produced in all three sectors. All three sectors means primary sector, secondary sector and tertiary sector. During a particular year, means within a year, provides the total production, means the total things that are produced in a country of the sector for that year is called the gross domestic product or GDP of the country, right? Means the total things that are produced within a country within a year is known as gross domestic product. More, the GDP means the GDP, if the GDP is more bigger the economy of the country is. It means the if the GDP is big, then the country economy is big. If the GDP is less, the country economy is less. Economy means related to money. So more the GDP, more bigger economy of the country is. So this is their GDP. And next thing is there historical change in three sectors. In the last video, we have discussed about three sectors, primary, secondary and tertiary sector. And in this video, we will discuss the historical change in the sector. Historical change, what kind of change? There is change in the primary to secondary and secondary to tertiary. And what kind of change is there? Let's see. At initial stage, initial means at the starting point of the development, when development began, what was there at the initial stage? Primary sector was the most important sector. We are using was. Was means it was there, but in the present time any other sector is there. At the initial stage, primary sector was at the top because most of the people were engaged in the primary activity related to agriculture. They were engaged in the agricultural activity. So what was there? There was the more contribution of the agriculture or the primary sector in the GDP earlier. But after that, what happened? With the innovation in farming methods, when the new methods of farming came into being, agriculture sector began to produce much more food than before. Means whatever things that sector were producing earlier, now it is producing more. After that, it was producing more. So what was there? When the crops or the food became more, then what happened? People started working in industries. Means we have read that the primary sector, secondary sector and tertiary sector, all three sectors are working hand in hand. And what is the use of secondary sector? That conversion of the raw material into the finished product. Here the things we are getting from the agriculture, that is raw material. And what happened after that? That raw material is need to convert into the finished product. So what was there? People started working in industries. Some people involved in transportation too. What was there in industries, industrial sector? I told you yesterday, I told you in the last video that what was there, industrial sector is known as the secondary sector as well as manufacturing sector. Primary sector, agriculture sector. Secondary sector, industrial sector or manufacturing sector. Tertiary sector, that is service sector. So, as they produce were more, then what happened? Industries began more, industries establishment was more, as well as the transportation came into being. So, gradually, secondary sector became the most important in the economy and providing employment. What was there? The employment shift from primary to secondary sector. Right? Gradually, secondary sector became more important in economy and providing employment. But what was there? Different industries related to food processing, equipments making, textile coming in large number. Now more and more industries were there. Now what the industries were doing? They were taking the material from the primary sector, they were using that and they were converting into the raw material, sorry, final product. Then what was there? Who will transport it? Now there was need of money, now there was need of banking, now there was need of transportation, right? So what happened? Now the share in GDP shift from secondary to tertiary. What was there? Different industries related to food processing, equipment making, textile coming in large number. This leads to start services. This leads to start services such as banking, health, education, etc. Health, education, etc. Right. So, the service sector is the most important sector in the present time. So, what is the, this tertiary sector, the contribution of the tertiary sector is most in the present time in the GDP. Right. So what is there? The service sector has become the most important sector in terms of total production and starting employing more people. Starting employing more people, what is there? Keep in mind that people are still engaged in large number in the primary activity. People are still engaged in the large number in the primary activity. But the contribution in the GDP is the tertiary sector is having more, right? So what is the GDP we have discussed and the historical change in the sectors, right? So next thing is there. What is the next thing that contribution in GDP we have discussed and factors behind the shift in contribution in GDP. What is their factors behind this shift in the contribution in GDP? What is there? First, earlier the primary was at the top, then secondary and now tertiary. So, now what is their factors behind this shift in contribution in GDP? The development of agriculture industry leads to the development of services such as transport, trade, storage, banking, etc. The development of agriculture and industry leads to the development of services such as transport, trade, storage and banking. And another thing, the greater the development of the primary and secondary sector, more would be the demand of such services. What kind of services? Like banking, transportation, health facility, trade, storage. These kind of facility will be needed more. Where are the most of the people employed? Where are the most of the people employed? I told you earlier what was there. The primary sector was the contribution in GDP of the primary sector was more and people were engaged more in the primary activity. Right. And in tertiary, what was there? When people were engaged more in the past time around 1773 or 1774. Right. So what was there? that where are the most of the people employed in the period during 1973-74, 40% is the contribution by the primary sector in GDP of the country, right? What is there in the period during 1973-74, 40% contribution of primary sector in GDP of the country. Secondary sector contributed only 12%. What was there during 1973-74? What was there? There were 40% contribution of primary sector in GDP. 40% of primary and only 12% contribution was there of the 12% contribution was there what was there in 1973-74? 40% people were engaged in the 40% contribution was there of the primary sector in the GDP and only 12% contribution was there of the secondary sector in the GDP and rest of the 48% contribution was there of the tertiary sector in GDP. But before that, what was there? Primary sector was at the top in the contribution of GDP, right? But in 1973, the tertiary came at the first point. So what was there? Secondary sector contributed only 12% and 48% is contributed by the tertiary sector. Employment percentage during the 1973 and 74, 74% people of India are engaged in the primary sector. What was there? That 74% people in 74% people were engaged in the primary sector, while only 15% people were there in the tertiary sector. What was there? You can see 74% people are engaged in the primary activity and they are only contributing 40% in the GDP. Only 15% people are engaged in the tertiary sector and they are contributing 48% in the GDP. Right. So what is their employment percentage during the period of 1973-74? 74% people were engaged in the primary activity and only 15% people were engaged in the tertiary sector, tertiary activity. So in 2013 and 14, what was there in 2013 and 14? So in 2013 and 14, what was there? The percentage of contribution of tertiary sector in GDP of the country increased and reached to the 67%. In what is there? 67% contribution is there of the tertiary sector. Tertiary sector in GDP. T means tertiary sector. Earlier, what was there in 1973-74? Only 48% percentage was there, share was there in the GDP, and now in 2013-14, 67% share is there in the GDP of tertiary sector. Right? The primary sector reduced to only 12%. Primary sector is only now 12%, right? The primary sector continues to be the largest employer during 2011 and 12. What was there in 2011-12? What was there? The primary sector was the most labor absorbing sector of the country, means most of the people are engaged are busy or engaged in the primary activity, but the contribution in GDP or that is there, more is there of the tertiary sector, right? So this thing is there. And now next thing is there, disguised type of unemployment. Types of unemployment. We have already read about the types of unemployment in class 9. But here we will discuss again. Number one, the disguised unemployment. Number one, the disguised unemployment. What is disguised unemployment? In disguised unemployment, people are appearing as worker, but their productivity level is zero. People are appeared as worker, but their productivity level is zero or less. How? Let's see. More people are engaged in agriculture than necessary. Mainly disguised unemployment is there in agriculture. What is there? Mainly disguised unemployment is there in agriculture. What is there? Suppose a field is there. Suppose this is a field. There is need of 10 people. There is need of 10 people. But what is there? 15 people are working. 15 people are working. If we will remove 5% from there, is there any effect on the production? No. There will be no effect on the production. So these five people are disguised unemployed. They are working, but their productivity level is zero. If we are dividing the work, then their contribution will become less. Suppose they were earning 10,000 rupees. Suppose from the field they are earning 10,000 rupees. If the contribution, if 10 people were working, their contribution was there each 1,000 rupees. Each contribution was there of 1,000 rupees. If 15 people, 5 were extra, right? Their the thing amount they will get the same, right? Divided by 15, suppose they will get the 7,500, right? So their working efficiency gone down. Right, this is disguised unemployment. This kind of underemployment is hidden in contrast to someone who does not have a job and is clearly visible as unemployed. It is also called the disguised unemployment. Right, how to create employment? And another thing, the types of unemployment, disguised unemployment and unemployment, seasonal unemployment. What is seasonal unemployment? Seasonal unemployment means in some season people are having the work, but in another season they are not having the work. Right? Like the farmer, like the ice cream maker. Some one season, in the summer season they are having the work, in the winter season nobody wants to purchase ice cream. So they are, what is their seasonal unemployment? And another thing, under unemployment. What is under unemployment? Under unemployment means, first thing, what is unemployment? The person is ready to do the work. The person is ready or willing to do the work, but on ongoing wages, but he or she is not able to get a job. He is not able to find a job, that is known as the unemployment. What is the under unemployment? Under unemployment means the person is doing the work according to that his capacity is more to doing the work or earning more, but he is earning less. That is known as the under unemployment. Right. And another thing, seasonal unemployment I told you. And now how to create employment? How to create employment? Let's see. Number one. Granting loans at lower rate of interest. What is there? Granting loan at lower rate of interest. Number one, granting loan at lower rate of interest. Number two, investing in infrastructure. What is there? Investing in infrastructure. Investing in infrastructure such as building a dam at suitable, such as building a dam Right. Number one, what was there? Number one was there that granting loans at lower rate. Granting loan at lower rate of interest. Another third one, increasing efficiency of transportation and storage. Increasing efficiency of transportation and storage. And number four, promoting small scale industries. Number four, promoting small scale industries. What was there? Increasing efficiency. Increasing efficiency of transportation. And what is there next? Increasing efficiency of the transportation. Next is promoting small scale industries such as mills, honey collection centers. Next is there emphasis on the education and training sector. Emphasis on education and training sector. Right. Next thing is there, identifying potential of an area. For example, an area can be developed as a tourist site. Next thing is there, government welfare schemes like making well or pump near farms, providing electricity, building hospitals, etc. These kind of things can be done by the government to create employment. Today it is enough, right? Tomorrow we will discuss about MNREGA and further about the chapter. Thank you. Be safe, be at home. Thank you.